run it over again, Mark.
Oh, and remember, he returned one against Bozeman last week, only to have it called back. Stefan H. will put his foot into the ball, through and hauls it in with the returning ball.
Kevin Cohen with the ball.
Up the middle, he's still on his feet as he crosses the 30-yard line. He's down about the 30.
Cohen threw about the 40.
And now it's Helena High at their own 35. In motion comes Brad Quist, your front back.
Lindquist, the ball carrier. Lindquist to about the 34.
So Lindquist, the tight end, Charlie Carson, the split end, Dave Nikovich. And again, here comes Quist in motion. He does a lot of running in motion. Back to pass. And it's probably will be putting the ball in the air frequently tonight. Out of the I formation, the Bengals have a first and 10, fully out on his own carry.
Ball stopped about the line of scrimmage.
By number 27, Tucker Rose came up from his strong safety position on first down. Ball still at the Billings senior 45-yard line. Pouliot calls the signal. Out of the I formation, the Bengals switch back into full house, and now over the middle of that pass. Penalty markers in the backfield. And again, possible motion penalty. Illegal proceeds. A good night for getting the football in the weather wise. Well, the penalty, the legal procedure against Helena High was declined by Billings Senior. Brings up a third and 10 situation. And Helena High comes running up to the line of scrimmage. Pouliot calls the signal. Out of the I formation, Quist will go into motion to the near side. And Pouliot is a keeper. Now he'll pitch it. Five. Nice option there by Pouliot. Be back to punt. He's at his 47-yard line.
Mayfield back.
Puts his foot into the ball. And
ball rolling into the end zone. Come out to the 20. Ball.
Senior offense, nothing to nothing to score. And right up the middle. And a quick
and out to Wharton, number 22.
Wharton
to about the 35, 36-yard line.
22, the right halfback, and he got a big game right up the middle going out the
Steve ball. Steve Lindsay and Kevin Cruen made the stop.
Landon in the backfield behind.
Wharton, the ball carrier. Wharton to about the 38.
And the yard. Castro makes the second and 8-6 to Rickett. Coming in motion comes Dan Rickett. And Castro. And in motion again to the other side, here comes Quist out of the I formation.
The back pitch. Quist off the ball carrier. Going to about the 22.
And in 4:16, the clock. Chris goes in motion. And Pouliot will call a timeout.
Just like Bengal timeout.
He'll come over to talk to head coach Henry Hamill. Or perhaps Coach Hamill will go out to talk to him. We'll take a 30-second timeout.
They're looking to do something here, get it in from about the 20-yard line.
Nikovich is split out wide to the left side. Quist is the flanker. No doubt he'll go in motion somewhere. Pouliot sets the Bengals, calls the signal. Long count. Now Quist goes in motion to the right side. And Pouliot will roll out to the left. It's a third down and 4. Here comes Quist out to the near side in motion. Pouliot will go back to pass. And from here, depending upon where they spot it, it
will
be so far into the first quarter, 4:56. And the ball at the Billings Senior 16, Quist in motion to give it to Fold up the middle.
Hold the ball carrier.
Inside of the block of Brad Mayo, and Fold has a quick game of about 2 or 3 seconds.
Hold to about the 13.
Down to the signals for the Bengals, knocking on the door of Billings Senior. No score yet, 4:19. Here comes Quist in motion to the near side. Pouliot will.
Pouliot keeping the ball.
The 8-yard line. Pouliot, senior's on 24-yard line. In motion comes Brad Quist. It'll be Pouliot giving it to him.
Yeah.
Bengals will go for 2 points. Could be a crucial play. Going for two, Pouliot at the helm of the Bengals. He calls the signal. It is Holden Lindquist in the backfield. Pouliot gives it to Lindquist, and he's not
going to... Lindquist trying the two-point right conversion fails.
A little stick put on him.
Bengals 6, Bronx 0.
Comes to the calling, and they stop. Billings senior, it looks to be number 11 again. That's Jeff Mayfield. Picked it up and
William
the outside, went right up to the sideline next to his teammate. Picked up some key blocks and a nice, about a 25-yard kickoff return by Mayfield. Here's that scoring drive summary for the Bengals. They lead it 6-0. They took six plays after recovering the fumble by Cosgrove. They covered 23 yards, and Lindquist ran it in from the 8-yard line for the score with 3:35 left. Here comes Billings senior, Cosgrove, will give it up the middle.
And
he is hit right at the line, then squirts on second effort for a gain of about a yard. So it'll bring up a second and 9, perhaps a second and 8. They give him a 2-yard gain. The Z-back, something new for the Billings senior offense. Head coach Tom Hopp looks on. Penalty flags flying over the field. A little bit of words exchanged there by the defensive line of the Bengals to the offensive line of Billings senior. I believe it's going to be offsides against Billings senior. Is there obviously had his signals crossed. He's going to have to get it together a little bit quicker here. So instead of second and 8, it's second and 13. The Bengals take the penalty. Ball resting at the 28-yard line of the Bronx. Sean Cosgrove, the quarterback, a senior, 170 pounds. Squirms. He's out to up to 33, 34. Well, as the signal squats deep beyond the center, he fakes the pass, and now he will pass it over. It throws the intended receiver, which was Dan Rickett, as he was crossing at about the 45-yard line. A penalty flag is down, and let's see what the infraction is. Billing senior looks like it is against them, as the Bengal players are moving to the deploying motion as they look to the sideline. 5-yard gain. They got back the loss of Lambden's sack in the backfield. So it's a 4th and 10.
Mikovich deep for the Bengals.
The line is clear. Stefanovic back to punt and nearly blocked, but there is no roughing the kicker penalty.
Mikovich for a catch. It'll be Bengal ball. First and 10 at the 42.
Save out and called for the fair catch. He hauled the ball in at the Bengal 42-yard line, and that's where the Bengal O line. Leading the game 6-0, Quist goes into motion to the far side out of the I formation. The give is to Lindquist.
Lindquist, the ball carrier.
Hit at the 43 after a gain of 1. I'm Billings senior on defense. Helena High's Rob Bulliak put
it on the back.
There's
a flag
of the field. He throws it deep. And Kevin Carson had the ball hit him in the wrong spot.
That's incomplete and good for Charlie Carson, number 83.
Carson had it back.
Stop number 36. Flag on the field. Preliminary indication against the Bengals. Penalty being set. The Bengals 15 yards. It'll be spotted 29 yard line. It'll bring a 4th down.
A nice tackle. He was the only man left for Helena High and brought him down hard.
Grabbing. The call is holding against the Browns.
Touching it off the sidelines with a man that I don't.
The ball will be spotted 20 yard line.
At any rate, it's a tough call for him, but it may give him a little confidence that they can lose the ball in big chunks. 2nd and 26 for Billing Senior. Ball at the broad 20 yard line. Now they start the clock. It's running with 9 minutes 30 seconds left here. You're going to go in the first half. He had a couple of big blockers out there, but Cosgrove may be feeling the pressure of the...
He did. He's 29 and had it at 3rd and 26.
Cosgrove with the pass. Intended for Komak, number 83.
Penalty marker.
Incomplete. There is a penalty.
Offside against LeBron.
Kevin Kerwin covering.
Bad for Kerwin. That hit him right in the chest. And generally, I don't think he missed those. I'm sure he wish he could have picked that one off.
Yeah, obviously, someone just lined up in the neutral zone, and that, of course, is a no-no. Stefanich back to punt for Billy Senior, and he's back inside his own 10-yard line, standing at about the 8. Back
Perez will be punting.
Is Nikovich, I believe.
Yeah.
hold of the long ball.
Doing about that last play was a pretty, or no, it was a
Mayfield, number 11, will be deep in the
ball. Wow, it looked like it was intercepted in the end zone, but as they came down with it, the wrestled away from the defender, and just the play earlier, he had dropped one when he was wide open in the end zone, so he made up for it. And another big penalty against Billings Senior, unsportsmanlike conduct, on top of roughing the kicker, and they're going to place the ball down at the Billings Senior 30. They're standing at the 30-yard line. Could that be right? They're at the 30. That's where Barch will tee it up. He might split the uprights from there. 17 seconds left, and Coach Tom Houck has to be a bit disappointed right now. They were in the ballgame 6-0 with 2:27 left and have given up two touchdowns in the last 2 minutes. And I would have to say that last one was a little bit controversial, Mark.
I think so. I don't think disappointed is the word for it. I think severe depression is more what you'd want to claim it. I really kind of feel bad for that defensive back because he was all over Carson there. They both went up for it. They both came down with it. And just kind of a matter of a tug of war there and the referee's opinion that gave it to Helena High. And now they're kicking from their, they're kicking from the Billings 30-yard line, and obviously probably a good time for an onside kick, an attempt to, believe it or not, make it 28-zip.
Well, I would question whether or not they're going to have an onside kick. Barks will, again, kick off from the Billings Senior 30. They do try to onside kick it, and Billings Senior picks it up. And the Bronx will return the ball up to about the 20-yard line. Clock stopped with 11 seconds on the change of possession. Helena High, 21, Billings Senior, nothing. We'll be back. Head coach Dave Miller, we're going to catch him before he goes down to the locker room. We'll be back in 30 seconds with... kicking is able to put into the ball at the 40, and back deep for the Bengals, picking up is Brad Quinn. He's at the 20, he comes to the outside, he's hauled down from behind.
Brad Quinn's the ball carrier to about the 21-yard line, it'll be Bengal ball, first and 10.
Brad,
Ted Pass, number 44, made the stop.
And then 11, Foliot calls the signals, Bengals out of the I formation, and Foliot does not, he gives it
right to the ball carrier,
worms his way up
to about the 25,
where he is brought down, right side is Nikovic, Foliot, the 50, takes a Bengal bounce, still rolls, and is knocked out.
Ball goes out of bounds.
For Bellick Sr., they go for a little different look. He is straight back to pass. He gets out the pressure. Beaton calls and signals, and that was a nightmarish way to start off the second half.
Beaton with the ball.
And throws it up for grabs, and he was nearly in the backfield. Anything after that. So they go with the sophomore quarterback, and Beaton again will go back to pass.
Beaton with the ball.
And the Bengals recovered it. The coach wanted to see. I imagine Cosgrove may be back in the game shortly.
Yeah, but one of the problems I don't think is that he can't substitute a new offensive line. That's what he'd really like to substitute because he didn't have a whole lot more time than Cosgrove had all night. So the Bengals are just blowing that offensive line back, and there's a lot of pressure. He doesn't have any time.
Well, there's no doubt who has the momentum. time in this game. The Bengals came out smoking and are in business at the 5-yard line. First and goal from the 5. Pulliot nearly fumbles the snap. And he will be hit immediately. He nearly dropped. So out of the I formation, Holt and Lindquist in the backfield. Pulliot, he'll take the back of Lindquist. Lindquist at the 10. And he'll be ridden out of bounds at the 8-yard line. Another loss of a yard. His crew, Quist, will go into motion to the far side. Nikovich split out to the near side. Pulliot will fake the handoff to Lindquist and will throw it into the corner. This is Quist. And he goes in.
Right through Holt's hands, but he just laid it in there, and be frank about it, Jay, my mom could have caught that pass.
And a new kicker in to try the extra point. This is number 75.
Took
a practice foul anyway, lining up that way. We don't have a check on that here in just a second. Well, we sent Bill Bowman. He's a sophomore, and he's a sidewinder. He wears number 75. They're going to give him a chance to kick it. Nikovich will be the holder. And it's a high snap. His kick is up. And the kick is no good. Wide to the right. So, Kenny Lee comes in and sidelines it. Just missed the upright. He almost nailed it. But it's 27-0. 8 minutes, 23 seconds left. We'll take a 30-second break. Helena High, 27-0 our score. Kevin Barch will be kicking off after the touchdown pass from Pulliot to Troy Holt. The ball is kicked at the 20 and quickly... Boyle picked it up, and right now he's wishing he hadn't. He was hit by 4 Bengals. And if we can get that, that's Robbie Ward.
David Beaton, the sophomore, he's back to pass. He lifts the throw, and it's overthrown.
Beaton passing incomplete.
For number 84, is it? 85, Kevin Boss.
Minutes, 34 seconds. Ward on a 23-yard run. The attempt for a 2-point conversion was no good. The kickoff now rolls into the end zone.
Formation.
They lead it by 21 points. It's 27-6. We're still in the third quarter. He has some blockers and he rolls across the 20 to the 22. Maybe there's any indication. We got a lot more scoring to go. Now it's Brad Quist in motion for the Bengals. He goes to the near side. And it's a
to
Holt. Holt is breaking up the middle line. He's across the center. He has a
first
running back to the far side. Holt and Lindquist in the backfield. Now Quist comes in motion to the near side. The pitch back goes to Lindquist. He gets around one man. He gets a stiff arm to another man and is ridden out of bounds. Just short of the 40-yard line. He picks up about 8 on a 2nd-and-1. But we'll see how they call it up here in the booth. Now the give is to Lindquist, and he fell close to the yard marker. Nikovich and number 44, Ted Press, having a little
see
with the Bengal coaches calling a 3rd-and-short. And it's a quick quarterback sneak. Pulliot
Quist,
the first down. Another first down. They'll move the chains. The ball is marked at the 43-yard line. The backfield, Holt and Lindquist. Lindquist the tailback, Holt the fullback. Nikovich split out wide to the right side. The give is to Holt around
this
side. And probably just as well because he had about 3 orange and white passing down here. I think they'll go to the air. 2nd-and-8 as Holt got a gain of 2. Pulliot rolls to his right and
will throw
down. And
that's
the 42-yard line. Pulliot just lofted it over his head. running. You might as well just stop there, sit up, look at people, and let her rip, because he's had a lot of protection, and he's kept running, and that hurts him. Third and eight is the call. Brad Quist in motion. Pulling out with
the
That's an effective play there. Lindquist close to 100 yards now in the rushing department. First and 10, Bengals. Here comes Quist, the motion man, comes to the near side. Pulliak gets it.
Oh, well,
some good yards. A couple of good backs for the Bengals. Out of the I formation, Pulliak calls the signals to give us to Lindquist. He has Quist down yards. It's not the 30 down to 29 yards. Good receiver. Here is Pulliak for the first and 10. Maybe a passing down. They're going to do. That was too bad. That was a real good run. He turned the corner nicely. Darnier had a touchdown on the thing, but someone was holding, according to the referees, and they're bringing it back. Really, though, Mark, the Bengals have not had many penalties. They have been real sharp in their execution here tonight so far, and I don't know what they're talking to Billings Sr. about. Obviously, they're going to take the penalty. Otherwise, they're going to be first and goal for the Bengals down at the 9. Now they decide, yeah, we'll take the penalty, and that was an obvious call. It's a big 15-yard penalty against the Bengals. They're back at the midfield. Back 15 yards from there, 20-yard loss for the Bengals. Here they go on offense. And Quist is in the burst to the far side. Pulliak goes straight back to pass. Now he has the pressure. He evades the tackle, and now he's sacked. That's the first sack of the evening. Second and 33. The Bengals face that type of situation. Obviously, a passing down, and Pulliak will roll to his left. And now he'll throw it deep, another 20. For sure. That is impossible in the flight of the ball exactly where it is. The other Billings people were upfield from it. It flew right over their head. He tipped it and got it. Nice catch. Third and 13. It'd be a miracle if they could pull off a first down here. Quiz goes into motion. Another passing situation. Pulley out rolls to the right. Now we're playing it down. And now we'll go back. Defensive line of the Bengals, the offensive line is just breaking down in the past. offense, actually.
It's Morton, the ball carrier.
And he stopped short of the first down. He got it up to the 48-yard line.
Success
passing at all. So we may see this time. I hope that we do see an attempt now on a high
point. Don't you think you deserve a little more? Capital Leasing can put you in an exciting new 1983 Mercury Cougar or a superb '83 Thunderbird. And all for as little as $199 a month on a 48-month lease. Check them out. They're the low speed boxes in Montana. Billings Senior Punt, Kevin Kerwin,
hauling in number seven.
He did try to set up a screw to the outside, but he got hit over there as he got up to the 14.
Paul
McCarroll.
Paul
McCarroll,
number
7. Quarterback for the Bengals. And he perhaps will see the fourth quarterback action here. Junior,
75 pounds. This is a big one.
And he will be taking over the helm next year. This year, they believe it. 28, is that?
Action, Jason Troy.
You're mentioning the sophomores. There's another try, John Try.
Oh, 16-yard
line, second down at about 8. Hey, Coach Henry Hamilton, there's a chance next year we could have a Troya backfield for Helena High School. Great, I'd love to see it. They got good speed, real good athletes, and a lot of that mission. Right up the middle that time for first down yardage. There's number 43. No, that's not 43. Check it. 47. Names that we're familiar with are gone, and names that are not on the roster start appearing, so we'll be the best we can. In motion comes number 81, Dane Sweater, to give us up the middle this time. McCarroll in running the offense for the Bengals, and that's number 40 out there, and that's
Troy, number 40, Troy, by Robert McCann.
42, Jeff McDonald is in the game. He is the running back. We couldn't pick up his number. So it's McDonald and John Trelia in the backfield. Out of the I formation, Paul McCarroll sets up the Bengals. They lead it 34-6. And it's a second and nine situation.
Rudy, you okay?
Get back there, set up, and look for receivers, and then throw it. That's the only way they're going
to get the ball resting 45-yard line.
Ball game, it looks doubtful, but I'd like to see Beaton have a chance to do that.
Flag on the field for any indication against the road.
What he's throwing the ball. Well, that time looks like Billings Senior was going to pass it, and Brent McLeod split out to the near side, and the top of this side is Quinn Falk, senior flanker, and Beaton will go straight back
Beaton
to pass.
With the ball.
And in on the sack, number 68 for the Bengals. Wouldn't you know it, there isn't a 68 on the roster. Well, that's a tune we've heard before. It's interesting, a sophomore quarterback like that will get back there, see all those jerseys coming at him, and just kind of freeze up.
he's not moving very quickly anyway, but when he sees those people coming at him, he doesn't have much foot speed. We're fully out of position. He gets back there, keeps things moving, and he's awfully hard to get a hold of. Third and 26 now for Billings Senior. Beaton will roll out to his
left. Beaton with the ball.
The man open downfield. Number 84 is wide open. He dives for it, and he can't get it. Number 84, Dan Ricketts, gave it a dive at the 27-yard line. Nice pass
that's
by Beaton.
That's number 84, incomplete, covered by Troy Williams.
Actually, it's a play ago that was in on the sack on quarterback Dave Beaton. Here's the pop, and it will punish. Possibly blocked by the Bengals, who just gets the Billings Senior bounce and will roll dead at about the 37.
Bengals will take over on their own 37.
Offense will go into play. Let's check some of the numbers as they go on the field. Number 28, Mike Johnson, the wide receiver, is in. And here comes Paul Vaccaro, the junior quarterback for Helena High School. Clock is now running. 7 minutes and 27 seconds left here in the ballgame. Billings Senior trailing the Bengals 34-6. Vaccaro calls the signals. Sweater goes in motion. The give is to number 28. Or check that.
Jason Troy, number 28, the ball carrier.
Troy is the ball carrier. And he gets into the far side of the field as a wide flanker. And the goalie is in the backfield. And number 81, I believe, also is coming across. Sweater is the guy who's taking Chris' position. Goes in motion most every play. Vaccaro will pitch back.
Vaccaro pitching out to McDonald.
Hit at the line of scrimmage. No gain, perhaps a yard line. Didn't have a
number 51 made the stop.
Was pummeled there by a couple of Brock defenders. Clock now running to the 6 minute mark of the final quarter. It's got some new offensive linemen in there, too, I believe. Jeff Hardiger's in there, Jim Sabonia. A couple of different people are moving in there to take over the offensive line duty. So they're doing a lot of substitution at this point. There goes Sletta in motion to the far side. Vaccaro, and a pass.
Vaccaro passing.
He'll air it out. And number 10.
Mark Twitchell, the intended receiver, incomplete.
To the wrong spot. Twitchell turned downfield. Vaccaro threw it to the sideline. And the Bengals coaches are calling it a night as they head to the locker room with a 28-point lead. Another punting situation, Mike. They got grins on their faces, too.
Good name and a good number for a linebacker, I guess.
Inside Bengal territory at the 49, Beaton takes the drop play, straight back to pass, gets some pressure, and now throws it to number
22. Pass incomplete, and good for Warden, number 22.
Corey Hall in, and drops incomplete, brings up a fourth and two.
John Lambert again covering for the
Bengals.
It has some good yards. Lambert's looking pretty good tonight.
Warden tried to run with that ball before he had complete control of it, and that doesn't work.
Dave Nikovich deep to receive for the Bengals.
Nikovich hauls it in.
Nikovich taking on his own 15. Flag on the field.
25-yard line, a couple of flags hit for that.
Preliminary indication against the Bengals.
A little bit, they had some wall set up, and people got a little over eager to make a good hit on people, and they did it from behind instead of the front. That'll cost them 15 yards, probably. We see the Butte High coaches here in the game now. They're, of course, here scouting the Bengals for the big showdown next Saturday afternoon. Between the Butte accepting the penalty or declining it, you'd have to think they would accept it. Being
the Bengals' next home game will be at 1:30 next Saturday. 1:30. Vigilante Stadium.
Left in the ball game, hands back of the ball, and put up a few more points. They've only scored 12 points coming into this game. They scored another 6 here tonight. And I believe they've only scored 6 points in every
clipping.
That's right. On the clipping penalty, Helena High will put the ball in play at their own 10-yard line. I believe we have another new quarterback. Number 13 is running the show. Let's check it on the roster. Number 13.
James Hodge, number 15, the quarterback now.
100% for everybody. So, Chance Hodge, the quarterback, running the Bengal offense. The give is up the middle to Troy again. He's across the 15 down to about the 16-yard line.
Penalty flags are on the field, and I believe it's offside against the Bronx.
Well, hell if they can get a playoff here. Who knows what they're going to do? I think that
the call against the Bronx.
It wouldn't really be running up the score at this point. Essentially, what it would be is
5 yards stepped
off. Quarterback, new receiver, no one else.
The ball will be spotted 35-yard line. First down, 5.
I wouldn't see it running the score. There's no guarantee, obviously, that they'll get it. I'd like to see it throw a couple times.
And officially, we have the Bengals with about 320 yards total offense, which is an impressive score, to say the least. Montero has numbers 10. Austin Mitchell split out to this side. Dane Sweater is in motion going to the far side. Montero will give it up the middle. The number 40.
Brody is the ball carrier.
Brody is the ball carrier, and he loses about a yard on the play. Clock is running down to 45 seconds left.
Chris Mark, number 69, down there to make a stop.
Touching the offensive line and having the regulars for Billings kind of push them out of the way. That gives them the Bengals substitute a little more respect for the Bengals starters, I'm sure, because the Bengals starters kept them out of there all game. 28 seconds, 27 seconds left in the game. Material signs the signals. Billy Packer, now he'll pick it back to number 40.
John Corey, the ball carrier, number 40.
Corners is headed. Billy Jr. had that one. Oh, diagnosed it. We're over there.
Chris Marsh again there in making the stop for the Bronx.
9 seconds, 8 seconds. That was the last play of the ball game. And when someone calls a timeout, it's certainly not a high one.
Please drive carefully on the way home.